set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Mustangs and their ground game's always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the load.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense, is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week, is tackling and gang tackling and getting to the football.
It's hard to get to guys and make tackles in space. From their own 27-yard line. Second down. He's got an opening. He's taken down at about the 41.
You're always looking for ways to get your playmakers involved, whether it's handing it off or just throwing it to them.
From their own 41-yard line. First down. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Lost the ball. Fumble. It's scooped up. He takes it right side for a good game. What happened on the option play there?
Well, you got to give credit to the defense. They knew what was coming, and they came up and made the play.
So the offense will come out for their first possession.
Good field position for their first possession of the ball game. Let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
They'll give it off here. Packer at the 26.
Second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gains his way to the 10-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
And ran with some real purpose there.
And he converts the extra point. It was a quick three-play, 34-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So the score now, 7-0. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Cougars are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
A fumble ended this offense's last drive. Let's see, as they come out on the field, what they'll do this time around.
Well, they're already playing from behind the eight ball, but they have plenty of time to get back in this thing.
Nice run there.
That's a deep seven. Second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle.
No good game of play. That makes it third and three.
Goes right around the 42-yard line. And that'll give him another first down.
Excellent job there, Brad, of running the football. That was good execution by this offense.
from their own 42-yard line. It's first down. It's the tailback. He makes it to the 42-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Gets 3 yards on the carry.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That makes it third and 7.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Tackle made at the 48.
That is just sound fundamental football right there, making it look so easy.
Off to the right. Levine gets about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it second and 6.
From the 44-yard line, it's second down. He's tackled at the 30.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Martin picks up about 4 yards after keeping the ball on the option. From the 26-yard line, second down. He's tackled at the 30-yard line.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
This is the 11th play of this drive. And he's taken down at about the 3-yard line. First down. So inside the 5 with a first and goal. Brought down at the 2-yard line. This is the 13th play of this drive. The stop just outside the goal line.
That makes it third and goal.
The offense is down by 7, so this is a very, very big third and goal. We're at the 1. So at the end of 1 quarter, the Cougars in front, 7-0. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Down. We'll be tied with the extra point. And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Miller gains around 3 yards on the option play.
This safety is as vicious a player as you're going to find. He will make the tackle every single time.
Second down and 7. Ball on the 28. Here's an opening. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. He's going to come up short. Good tackle.
It looked like he might pick up a head of steam and get the first, but the defense collapsed on him before he could get there.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He really got a hold of that one. Oh, man, did he take a hit. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And he is drilled at the 36-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Strike complete. He's down. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Makes it to the 37. Pickup.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That brings him second and 5.
From the 33-yard line, it's second down. He gets to about the 24-yard line. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
Bringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
Quick throw out to the receiver. They'll bring him down right around the 16-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Here's the 8th play of the series. He makes it to the 15-yard line.
That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. It out to his receiver in a hurry. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. And this is the 10th play of the drive. And they pick up the first down with a pass to the tight end.
It's easy to forget about the tight end sometimes coming off the line, but you always have to watch this guy because he's...
And they'll score. On the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
And 2.
makes it to the 34. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's taken down around the 41-yard line. Barnes picks him up around 7 yards with that catch.
And how about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past the sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
Flips it middle to the running back. Tackled at the 44-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
He's going to try and scramble. And down he goes around the 44-yard line. Scrambling. He's at the 40. He's knocked out of bounds at the 37-yard line. From the 37-yard line, first down. He's on the run. Dives, and he's down. He steps out at the 29-yard line. This is the 8th play of this drive. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. And he might want it all here. He's got it. Touchdown.
They looked awesome on that play. A well-thrown football and a great effort to get the ball into the end zone.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he hits the PAT. It was an 8-play, 76-yard drive. They come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Tackle made around the 42-yard line. The Mustangs call a timeout. That's their 2nd of the half. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. It's up, looks long enough, and he just drilled it from long range. This kick return should conclude the first half. Don't be surprised to see some trickery here. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing, how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback's put the ball right on the money.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two gangs match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
Very close game now as we start the second half. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Feeds it to the back. And they push him out at the 42-yard line.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run. And that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
From their own 42-yard line, it's first down. There he goes. Gets out to around the 45. Makes it out to about the 30. From the 30-yard line, first down. Makes it out to about the 20. Sacked.
I mean, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see. Your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
From the 25-yard line, second down. He's got it with room to run. And that sets them up with a first and goal. Defense stacked in tight here. Quick throw, caught, touchdown.
You know,
this entire group functions so well as a unit, and you saw it on that touchdown. Very good team effort.
He makes the PAT. Breedlove has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Nice gain as he works the right side.
That's a good 6 or 7. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's to the 40, and he's tackled right around the 46-yard line. Complete. He's got space to work. Knocked out of bounds at about the 39-yard line.
First down.
From the 39-yard line. First down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's a deep 7 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
He might have a chance.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
Number 26 with the tackle at the 23-yard line.
From the 23-yard line, it's second down. Run, and he's brought down.
That'll make it 35.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. He gets rid of this one. It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. Kicks away, and it is good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Man, both offenses here in this third quarter have been on fire. Time for the defense to step to the forefront a little bit.
Makes you wonder which of these defenses has the ability to come up and make a stop. It could be one of those games where whichever defense comes up with that stop could be the team that wins the game.
Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. Now he tries to buy some time, and he's taken down right around the 30.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
From their own 30-yard line, second down.
Go
action. He'll scramble.
And they make the stop.
At about the 33-yard line.
3 yards there on the quarterback keeper.
Third down.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Makes it to the 41.
Execution I like to see. Being one-dimensional on first down can really stack the odds against you. It's better to mix it up.
From the 42-yard line, it's first down. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. The Cougars lead it by one. Back to the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter. Up the middle for a nice game. So with that run, they pick up another first.
It's a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
Got a man. Watch out here. He's tackled at the 19. Here's the eighth play of the series. With room to work. They'll bring him down around the 9-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. And he carries the ball for a nice game. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Defense and their short yardage package. They'll go ground, and he gets the touchdown. He splits the uprights with the extra point. They're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. The Mustangs having everything going their way right now. They have put up 20 straight points on the board. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Makes it to the 34.
That's a deep that brings in second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start. Offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Slings it, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 36-yard line.
Game seven. First down.
From their own 36-yard line, first down.
five wide. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. Tackle at the 37-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Personal foul. Clipping. Offense.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. So it's first down and an eternity. Just under three to go in regulation. Looks middle, got his back, and down he goes at about the 49.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
Tight end grab, first down. And he's immediately tackled. From the 37-yard line, first down. And they'll bring him down behind the line. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Tackle made at the 28-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive.
Let's go, D. Watch 36. 36 to Mike.
He tackles him for a loss. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. You can talk about offense all you want, and they were good today, but the defense was better. They come up with a play of the day, and that'll lead to the victory. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And they get nice yardage on that run. Barnes gets 6 yards on the carry. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Makes it to the 35-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. The Mustangs are going to call their second timeout. And he just gets rid of it. So the defense gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
Ford is back deep to return the punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Levine's a guy that lives for moments like this. He's got a chance to win this football game for his team.
Well, it's a crucial moment in this football game where one play could be the difference and really determine the outcome of this game. You got to think the offense is going to find a way to get him the football and see if they can give him a chance to win this game.
He's tackled around the 44-yard line. Going deep. Incomplete.
I'll tell you, if he put a little bit more air under that ball, that would have allowed the receiver to run right underneath it and catch it right in stride.
From their own 44-yard line. Second down. Quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment and in position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there. But I love the toughness here by this quarterback. Sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Just gotta love it for this defense. They come up with the stop of the ball game and maybe the season.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
9 times out of 10, the defense will make a stop on that play, but you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it. You know, this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. From the 39-yard line, it's second down. Under a minute left in the game. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. Into the tailback, and he's met in the backfield. And the ball game's over. The Cougars get the victory, 28-20. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.